BBC Radio Berkshire.
...1,300 flights leave Heathrow every single day. They're all given clearance for takeoff from the air traffic control tower, and we're going up there now to see what they do.
Welcome to the control tower. We are going to head straight up into the lift and take you right to the very top.
Grand. It's very swish in here.
Well, thank you very much. We try and keep it clean. So we're going to hit number 8.
Number 8.
We are about to pop out of the base building of the tower in towards Terminal 3.
Wow.
And then out to the west is Terminal 5. And now we're only seeing a tiny section of the airport here. Once we get to the very top, we'll see a full 360-degree view. And we're up to the top. We're already there.
And we go up. We're going to have an amazing view of the airport. Look at this. So we're on the balcony. How high are we here?
We're just a few metres from the top, so we're about 85 metres up. So we're looking out towards the west, and we've got Terminal 5, which is pretty much the entire British Airways operation in one place. And this is only half of the airport. There's a whole other side of it around the other side.
And how many flights per day do we have leaving here?
There are 1,350 flights every day.
And every single one has got to be cleared for takeoff by your guys up there?
That's right, yeah.
What's going on up there right now?
Well, what the controllers up there are responsible for is every aircraft that is moving on the airport. So when you go on holiday, you get on the flight. Whilst you're actually strapping yourself into the seat, the pilot is already talking to air traffic control. He's finding out the route that he's going to take, the weather that he's going to have en route, and all the other bits and bobs about the flight. Once he's ready to go, he's then transferred onto ground control. So they will clear the aircraft to push back, making sure that there's no other aircraft around. He then taxis out towards the runway holding area using the taxiway system at the airport. And once he gets there, he's transferred to the next controller, who is the runway controller. Their job is to get those aeroplanes at the holding area, shuffle them all up to get the most efficient departure order. Now at Heathrow, getting the most efficient departure order is absolutely crucial because you don't want to waste a second. All of those aircraft in that little queue will have been transferred to the runway controller, and what they're going to do is then move those aeroplanes into a really efficient sequence so that we might have one takeoff and fly to the south, and then one to the north, and then south, north, south, north, to keep the whole thing going fairly smoothly.
How much of what goes on up there is done by looking out of the window, and how much of it is done by keeping your eyes glued to a computer screen?
Well, actually, the real name of the control tower is a visual control room, and the emphasis is on the visual bit. So the controller has a full scan of screens that he looks at, but the biggest and most important screen is this window. So he's looking out the window, and then he verifies things by looking at the radar, looking at the weather screen, looking at the surface radar, but then always back out the window to see what's actually going on. And he controls all the traffic using Mark 1 eyeball.
You have airlines from all over the world flying in here. Do all of the pilots speak English, or do your guys up there have some language skills too?
Well, thankfully for me, the language of the air is English, and we are very, very fortunate to be in that position. There are airlines here serving well over 100 countries, so the range of backgrounds and accents is very, very broad. We have got lots of different procedures for dealing with things like bad weather or aircraft emergencies. The controllers are trained to react to those kind of situations by just re-vectoring those inbound aircraft around back to try for another approach. So there are procedures for pretty much all of the emergencies and all of the unusual occurrences that we have at Heathrow.
So now we're here in the control room itself. It's completely different to how I would imagine it to be. Everybody seems relaxed. There are screens everywhere. One in front of me here seems to show the entire layout of the airport. And just in the background, you can hear in very, very calm voices, no raised tones at all, the controllers giving their instructions. I suppose it's such an important part of the job. They have to be clear and concise. It's got to be the room with the best view in the entire airport.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on.